So the answer to this question is that exons are considered part of protein-coding DNA because exons are eventually turned into protein. And the same is true for translated sequence between start and stop codons. They're all part of protein-coding DNA because the sequences that make up that DNA are eventually turned into protein. And these other regions, like introns, which are spliced out of mRNAs, promoter regions, which are responsible for initiating transcription, and untranslated sequences that are transcribed in part of the mRNA but outside of the start and stop codons, are all considered part of non-coding DNA. So hopefully, if you truly understand the concepts of coding DNA versus non-coding DNA, you will understand why each of these types of DNA sequence would be categorized or classified as either protein coding or non-coding. If you're having any trouble with these concepts, check out the forums and see what some of your classmates have to say. If I notice there's a lot of trouble, I'll try to post some clarifying information there or in the instructor's notes.